Good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Dr. Satyabhusan Senapati, Consultant Neurosurgeon, JP Hospital, Rourkela. Today, I will be speaking about brain stroke. So, brain stroke is a very common cause of morbidity and mortality nowadays. Even the younger age people are now suffering from brain stroke. So, what do you understand by brain stroke? So, by brain stroke, we mean that suddenly brain stops functioning because of lack of blood flow to a particular part of brain. So what are the types of brain stroke? So you have to understand that brain gets its blood supply through blood vessels. Suppose there is a blockage in any part of your blood vessel supplying the brain, then a particular part of brain supplying getting the blood flow stops functioning. So this is a type of stroke, we call it ischemic stroke. Another type of stroke is hemorrhagic stroke. In that case, the blood vessel supplying the brain ruptures, so that inside the brain parenchyma we get a bleeding. So basically there is one is ischemic stroke, another is hemorrhagic stroke. There is another kind of stroke called TIA or transient ischemic attack or mini stroke. So in mini stroke, the symptoms of the stroke, it lasts only for few minutes. So after few minutes, all the symptoms gets reversed spontaneously. So this is otherwise known as mini stroke. So we shouldn't neglect this mini stroke because it is a warning sign. If we will not take proper intervention or proper care, we may get a major stroke in near future. So what are the warning signs by which we can suspect that a person is going to have a stroke? So by warning sign, we understand that our body gives some symptoms that indicates that our brain is not getting a sufficient amount of blood flow or oxygen. These warning signs are like any facial asymmetry. There's asymmetry in the both of your face. You may have a difficulty in speech, that is otherwise known as slurring of speech, or weakness in any part of your body. If you are any of your family members, you are observing these symptoms, then you should bring the patient to a nearby hospital as early as possible, because timely intervention can prevent can recover the complete stroke symptoms. Then what are the risk factors for a stroke? Who are the people who are very much prone for this stroke? These are the people who have uncontrolled very high blood pressure, uncontrolled blood sugar level, that means a high uncontrolled blood sugar. Third is who is a regular smoker, alcohol intake, who have sedentary lifestyle, who are obese, very high blood cholesterol level. These people are very prone to have a stroke. So how can we prevent a stroke? So we can prevent the stroke by maintaining a healthy lifestyle. That means we have to stop all our bad habits like smoking, alcohol intake, our sedentary lifestyle should stop. We should do a regular exercise and healthy diet. By this means, we can prevent a stroke. Thank you.